Hi, I'm Ariel Felton.
My name is Mykesha McFall, and I am the lead choreographer and guest teaching artist for this year's show.
And I'm Marquise Williams.
We are teaching artists for Deep Center's Block by Block program, which is a year-long creative writing, leadership, research, and community building program for Savannah's high schoolers.
Each year, our Block by Block artists have the opportunity to connect with adult artists, allies, and community stakeholders and ask the question, how is the community I'm from affecting the person that I'm becoming?
This year, our focus was on the school-to-prison pipeline, which means that we looked at issues of oppression, resistance, healing, and liberation, and how those topics intertwine with our school system and our juvenile justice system here in Savannah.
And then in March, right as we were preparing for our final showcase, a pandemic stopped us in our tracks. So this year, instead of bringing you our normal in-person show in front of hundreds of people, we're doing something a little bit different.
Too many high schools today are forced to reckon with tragedy. Too many of our young people are not making it to graduation, and we are doing too little to make change. And we must ask not only how we can make change, but what we have done to shape their world this way. How are we responsible? What burdens are we placing on our young people? What tools are we keeping from them? How did we get here? Again.
Until you're on your knees. You ain't taking my son, you won't get past me.
Block by block, feel the city rock. Tension.
Today is the day that I go, so my name and my story is something you should know. Earlier on, and even now, I accepted any challenge from any foe. But life proved time and time again that it's not easy to be the best. I felt that I could do anything. I strived to be the best. I figured I could do anything as long as a heart beats in my chest. But I was wrong, and more disappointed than my ambition could bear. The flames of desire were slowly extinguished. My heart needs a new way to be distinguished, or I'm done. I'm done. The heart travels along a path. The path is strange, but slowly the heart reaches a standpoint and it sees a sign. It's a one-way sign, and the sign says wordsmith. Wordsmith, 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 as many times as the heart beats. My brain remembers wordsmith, wordsmith. This must be the way, says the heart. As the heart keeps walking, it eventually begins to beat faster, as if it's coming back from the slow, depressing beat it was once encaged in. The heart beats faster, faster, as if I'm about to have a heart attack, but it's excitement, joy. I feel relieved. The heart found a way to be distinguished, something that makes it beat frantically. And along the path, it continues. It meets a standpoint. It meets a standpoint. It drops down into this hole and meets many other hearts. And these hearts are just like this one. They are wordsmiths. They tell him that being a wordsmith is not about being the best. It's about being the best that you can be and projecting it through your art. The heart begins to beat slower and slower because it's going back into the hole of depression it was once in. As if this is not something that it can be proud of, boast, or brag about. But then the heart remembers the joyful times that it experienced being a wordsmith. All the writing, all the poems, all of the expressions that it felt brought joy. So, turns out these aren't my last words. I'm a survivor. These aren't my last words, just the beginning of many more for the heart to create.
It's getting harder to breathe. My lungs feel like they're closing. But it's all psychological, yet the pain, it still has a hold of me. I can't breathe, I can't see, I feel so dizzy. Okay, I just want someone here to say, breathe with me. I fall to the floor, feeling so pathetic and weak. I'm a mistake, I blame myself, the two phrases. My mind plays on repeat. Nothing is helping, I just hold myself tight. Trying to keep my cries silent so that my family can sleep alright. Is there a cure for this? My whole body is shaking. Times like this, I don't feel like I will ever make it. I feel like I'm losing my happiness and myself along with it. I feel like it's only going to get worse from here. I have to get better for the few people who want me here. I know I'm loved, yet I don't feel enough. These types of thoughts will never leave, but I'm too stubborn to give up.
I'm the heat you feel in your face in an argument, the urge to scream and cry, the gritting of teeth, the tense muscles and heavy breath. I am anger. I'm the sinking feeling in your chest, the cold that freezes you over, the hopelessness in your heart, the numbness that leaves you empty, the wanting to cry without the strength to. I am despair. I'm the instinctual head down, the close your eyes and run away, the blood rushing to your face, the sweaty palms and sinking gut, the wobbly knees yet urge to run. I am shame. I'm that burning feeling in your chest, the smile that creeps on your face and you just can't get rid of, the urge to fake modesty, the inability to stay still. I am pride. And I am a mix of emotions.
We delicate moths who flutter wings in the dark, searching for a home, we are worn down, tired. Wings are torn by a dark night, but hope comes to us, a drizzle, a sliver of light. We can see the moon. And unlike those fiery matches, those lantern lights who burn our fine wings with their scorching bite, these lights, they have a peaceful glow in the dark, raging night. So let our wings flow up to the heavens where the pale moon sleeps and a bed full of stars breathe through an impressive light.